Welcome. We're finally here, Montana, after 2,500 plus miles of flying, couple days, good food, good drink, and better company. And we're going to witness a special day for these two women, Samantha and Rebecca. We've been doing it since we got in, but look around. I mean, breathe it in. There's going to be pictures and video, but remember this feeling. It's unbelievable backdrop. Beautiful place. Couldn't ask for a better day. So, like I said, we're a long way from home, and you two are a long way from 8 years ago at Endicott.
Oh boy.
No, I won't go in. Becky did a nice write up on the website. I'm not going to rehash that. But 8 years ago, it was a little bit of distance, and then we moved to Pittsburgh for a couple years. Was it three apartments in 3 years? Smaller apartment?
Yes.
So, can't test the relationship much more than that. Moving to a new city, new place, tight living quarters, and all that.
All the house.
And then came back north to Cohasset. And that's when I came in. So, the pleasure of living them for, the past 2 years on and off. But we'll get back to that later. So before we get to that, I asked them some questions, and I sort of knew the answers I was gonna get before they wrote back. But so I was a little unsurprised there. But what's surprising is they use almost the same language when I asked them to describe each other and things to know about the other one. I had a feeling it would work this way, and it did. So both talked about how caring and selfless the other is and ready to drop everything at a hat for friends, family, for each other. And I've witnessed it. They've both been ready to, again, be by someone's side when needed, if needed, and even if you don't need it, they're there. Becky, you talked about how you feel at home with Samantha and how she can calm you and give you exactly what you need. Similarly, Samantha, you call Becky your calming force, your person for everything. Again, it's two things I've been lucky enough to witness between the two of you. I also asked what people should know about the other. Here, Becky'd Samantha said Samantha had a weird side to her. I opted not to follow up on that and learn exactly what that was. But in one of Samantha's responses, she said, Becky brings out brings her out of her shell and brings, I think, you know, brings her something she probably didn't feel on her own, made her feel comfortable and all that. And that's very powerful. Overall, these answers showed how they truly complement and complete each other. They're exactly what they need and bring out in the best in one another. Now, back to Cohasset and living with these two. So all of what I said, I've seen firsthand how they're there for each other. Samantha, I've known you, your whole life.
Mm-hmm.
And I've never seen you as happy, as caring, and in love with someone as you've been with Becky. So it, you know, while we grew up together and, you know, away from college and living together again, I got to see this whole new side of you. And Becky, I just got to learn about you. You know.
More than you wanted to know.
I didn't say that yet, but I, you know, in passing, sort of as you would, you know, visit time to time before each of us were living in Cohasset, I'd, you know, see that Jeep out front with the flower-covered wheel cover and ask, who's that again? Oh, tie-dye. Flower tie. I was like, who's that again? Oh, it's Becky. All right, I'll get to know her one day. And we have, and couldn't ask for more. You're so selfless, willing to listen, ask all the right questions, and just a fun person to be around. You know, it's great. You can make a joke, and you know Becky's laughing because you can hear her from the next room or the next room over from that, maybe the upstairs. So, you know it's a good time when Becky's laughing. And I know, you know, after this ceremony and before I called you my sister, but you've felt like my fourth sister for the past 2 years. So. I don't have like a big overall arching story that sums up everything that these two are, but I do have all these little things, these daily moments between you two that make you so great. Just those small gestures that I see day to day, whether it's Becky, you're coming home late from work or working out, and Samantha's prepping, you know, just a dinner plate for you to get ready. And then you're making lunch the next day for everyone. It's just all these little things that show how much in love you are with each other and want to do everything for each other. You've gotten her to play cards too. We all love games, and Samantha not so much, but even that, we've brought her out to do that. But the greatest thing I've been able to witness, do yourself a favor when, and I'm talking to everyone out here, when one of them is in a room and the other's entering, whether they've been apart for the day or for 5 seconds, take a look at one of their faces. There's, watch how their expressions change and their eyes lift. It's, again, it could be 5 seconds, and it's the same for both of them. You see just emotions lift, the joy in their faces, and how they care for each other. I'm not sure they're even aware of it, but it's for both. You can see it. You can watch them come in, and I think that it's just because they want to be close to each other again. And again, whether they've been apart for long or not, it's as soon as they're back together, everything's lifted up. And it's amazing to see. That's my favorite thing I've been able to notice these past 2 years. It's just that joy between the two of you. So, relationships are work. Continue to work. Be happy. And love each other every day. That's all I can say. I love you guys.
I love you guys.
So, with that, we'll bring up the rings and the vows.
Yeah, so, we'll start with the
Evan and
vows.
Bree.
The vows first?
Yeah.
You want to go first or me go first?
Yeah, we're going to discuss this.
What do you want to do?
Don't matter. I can go first.
Okay.
I'm going to throw my phone back to you in a second, Kylie. Just got to pull one thing up. All right, I'll open up a little bit so you all can see my beautiful face.
Oh my god.
inches. All right, let's take it back to the beginning. So I'm sure you've all read our website very thoroughly, as you all should have. But if you didn't, Becky and I first met sophomore year of college at Alternative Spring Break, which was just Habitat for Humanity down in Laredo, Texas. Funny enough, Alternative Spring Break is one of the couple of reasons I chose Endicott, so the fact that I found you through that is just beyond. But so we were heading down there to build houses for Habitat for Humanity. Luckily for me, my first true interaction with Becky was I was already sitting in a plane seat, and here she comes laughing away down the aisle, sits right next to me, and just starts talking and never stops. And one of the first things that she did, and this really showed who she was, was she did a full rendition of Kristen Wiig from Bridesmaids of the airplane scene, where she freaked out and was, you know, on something, and Becky did a spot-on impression. So that, to me, gave me the biggest shock, but it also made me incredibly comfortable right from the beginning. Luckily, she did stop talking at some point, and I was able to relax for the rest of the plane ride. But reason I bring up Alternative Spring Break is not just because that's where we became friends and where we met each other. One of the things that we had to do as we were leaving the trip, which it was a very tough trip. There was car crash, train derailment, you name it. It was quite the adventure. But at the end of it, we all had to write notes to each other person that went there. I don't know if you remember what you wrote on mine, but I'm going to go ahead and share that with you all now.
Oh my God, I guess you still have it.
So, I don't know how I still have it, but I took a picture of it, funny enough, so I have it here. So word for word. So first she writes, Sam C, BFF. This is 1 week of knowing each other. She goes, dearest new best friend who, what can I even say about how quickly our friendship grew? I knew when we sat together that we would be friends/BFFs. You were so funny for words and stoic. I've loved spending time with you this week and taking model pictures of you every day. Secretly, you're the Hulk, and I fear that you'll beat me up someday. But I am willing to take the risk to be your best friend. I will sign pictures of you under your door and get best friend necklaces. You are a genuine person, and I really enjoy you as a person. I hope we stay friends for life. And here's the part they have to listen to. It says, maybe I will marry your brother, and we can become sisters. You're awesome, one of my favorite people. God. Love you so much. So, you're not marrying my brother, but he is marrying us. Yeah. I hope that's enough of a consolation prize for you.
That's good.
Had to share that one. Moving on. So we graduated college. Both had a lot to figure out, helped each other out in a lot of different ways. Becky helped me with my confidence, learning to love myself and who I am. We've done long distance, as Ryan said, multiple moves, multiple areas. We have moved to a new state together, new jobs, more education, new jobs, and much more. And then we made it back to Massachusetts. We leaned on each other during deaths and hard times. I wouldn't have wanted to spend the last 9.5-ish years with anyone else. Becky, you have taught me how to be open. You taught me that it's okay to not be okay. You have broadened my way of thinking, supported my crazy profession and its lovely schedule that comes along with it, and brought me into an incredible group of your friends. I did not grow up thinking about a wedding like most little girls did. I just played sports with Ryan in the backyard and did as the boys do. And when I started to find myself, I wasn't all too sure what marriage would look like, what a wedding would look like for me. But I'm lucky because you've given me the vision of that. A life and a family I can now dream of with you. You are caring, expressive, and the life of the party. You're studious, you're empathetic, and you're very captivating. I cannot wait to begin creating a family together, along with our many chickens and pets we will undoubtedly
don't
have.
Don't forget rabbits.
And rabbits. Becky, you are my best friend, you are my person, and I love you.
Love you. Well, I don't know. That's like a tough act to live up to. It was like a show. Mine's more of like a letter.
Okay.
Dear Sam, I can't believe where we are, physically speaking. How lucky am I that I found someone who a year ago said, let's do it, when we first envisioned our wedding in a national park. And we're crazy enough to get all these crazy people to fly out here with us. I never imagined how my life would turn out. For many years, I never thought I wanted to get married or have kids. The perfect life wasn't for me. I never felt normal enough to want those things. I also just didn't think it was attainable. I thought in order to be different, I had to do things differently. But clearly a lot has changed. When we met on a plane, headed to spring break in Texas, I never could have pictured how our lives would have unfolded. And then connected again 2 years later in the Bahamas, I again had no expectations. When we said goodbye at graduation, I was scared that was the end. But as the months went by and turned into years, my love continued to grow, and the unknown still hung around like a cloud. There was so much we didn't know. What would we do with our careers? Where would we live? What would our families think? But time continued to pass, and still we stayed committed. When my life began to fall apart, you didn't back away. Instead, you stood by me and supported me through the worst times in my life. You have been a guiding light when I was truly lost. There were days when I didn't know I'd make it to tomorrow, but you always have reminded me that there can always be a tomorrow. Aside from the hardships, I realized that I wanted to get married after living in Pittsburgh together. Finally, we saw what it would be like to spend time full time together instead of living long distance, which we had endured for so many years. Creating our own space / happy place has truly brought me so much joy. I loved all of our apartments, even the hobbit hole that became a prison during COVID. COVID also made me realize how much I hated being apart. But Sam, I promise this. I promise I will always be by your side, no matter how hard life gets. I will face all the storms, just as you had done for me. I will always say yes to adventure, living life to the fullest, and trying new things. I will embrace every day with gratitude, as it's another day I get to spend with you. I will continue to love the heck out of you, as well as your family and all the people you love. And though I'll never stop talking, I will always try to listen more. I will try to clean up my clothes and clothes drawers as well. There are so many things about you that I love. Your calming presence, your dependability, your selflessness, your love and loyalty to your family, and that you never try to dull my crazy, but you bring me back to earth, reminding me that not every problem needs to be solved in a day. Like I said, when I met you, I had no idea what our future would hold, but I quickly realized I couldn't imagine a future without you. I loved you yesterday, I love you today, and I will love you for all the tomorrows to come. I love our life together. I even love living in the adult household. I can't wait for more fireside chats, busies and babies days, and to create a perfect life together. Love you.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, now we need the
dry eyes out there.
Yeah, Kylie.
What'd you say?
Is there any dry eyes out there?
No.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna put the ring on Becky's finger.
Ooh, look at this.
There we go.
Squeeze it on. There we go.
I need to switch it.
And Becky's on to Samantha. the vows and the rings exchange, it's my honor to declare you married and partners for life. You may now seal the vows with a kiss.
Married again.
I can do another kiss
one
without you.
I'm fixing my dress.
Alright.
Oh my gosh. I'm stuffing all over the dress. Wait, do open. Oh, no. Okay, say.
Ready? We got limited time. It's gonna pop. Ready?
Covered.
All right, we have to find that cork, though. Ready?
Got the hair.